Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, 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 Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Gaur Premanande, Harinam Sankirtan ki jai, Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Nitai Gaur Premanandi. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshuran Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Sayang Rupa Kadamaiham Dadatisya Padantikam Bande Aham Shri Guru Shri Juta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsya Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanitam Tam Sajivam Svadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Nitangsya Namo Ung Vishnu Padayo Krishna Prishthayo Bhutali Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tarine. Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaivacha Patitanang Pavanebho Vaishnavebho Namo Namaha. Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurati Se Namaha. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpati Gopesa Gopika Kanto Radha Kanto Namastuti. Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Brinda Vaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Prem. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vas Adi Gaura Bhakta Brinda. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Srimad Bhagavatam, King Yajati Achieves Liberation, Canto 9, Chapter 19, Text 26. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Madhirai. Astopaya Swabhadrishu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavate Uttamasloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishthiki. So text 26. Srutva gathang divajani mene prastavam atmanha stri pungso snehe vaiklabhyat Parihasam iveritam Srutva gatham divajani Mene prastubham atmana Stri pungso sneha vaikrublat Parihasam iveritam Srutva gatham divajani Mene prastavam atmana Stri pungso snehe vaiklabhyat Parihasam iveritam. Srutva gatham divajani Mene pratvam atmana Sri Pungsasne Prabhat Parihasam Iveritam. parihasam veritam. Srutva, hearing, Gatham, the narration, Devajani, Queen Devajani, the wife of Maharajati, Mene, understood, Prastavam Atmana, when instructed for her self-realization, Sri Pungsa, between the husband and wife, sneha vaiklavyat, from an exchange of love and affection, parihasam, a funny joke or story, eva, like, iritam, spoken by Maharaj Jayati. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. When Devajani heard Maharaj Jayati's story of the he-goat and she-goat, she understood that this story, which was presented as if a funny joke for entertainment between husband and wife, was intended to awaken her to her constitutional position. Purport. When one actually awakens from material life, one understands his real position as an eternal servant of Krishna. This is called liberation. Mukti hitvartha unnatha sarupam na vyavasthita. Bhagavatam 2.10.6. Under the influence of Maya, everyone living in this material world thinks that he is the master of everything. Ahankara mulatma karta ahamiti mannate. One thinks that there is no God or controller, and that one is independent and can do anything. This is the material condition, and when one awakens from this ignorance, he is called liberated. Maharaj Jayati had delivered Devajani from the oil, and finally, as a dutiful husband, he instructed her with the story about the he-goat and she-goat, and thus delivered her from the misconception of material happiness. Devajani was quite competent to understand her liberated husband, and therefore she decided to follow him as his faithful wife. This is the end of this purport. Hare Krishna. This chapter, we can understand, it is very difficult for those who are too attached to material enjoyment to give up the activities of sense gratification. Like Jayati, everyone's life sometimes happened like this, but if initially he understand, then very good. Otherwise, it is very difficult to come from that type of entanglement, because this situation and nowadays situation is completely different. What is the source of this misery? Lord Krishna instructed in Bhagavad Gita, Jehi Sangsparsaja Bhoga Dukha Janaya Yavate Adyanta Vanta Kanto Note Suramate Buddha. The intelligent person does not take part in the source of the misery which due to attachment of material senses, O son of Kunti, Adyanta Vantuka Note Suramate Buddha. Such pleasure have beginning and end. So a wise man does not delight to them. So we understand what is the source of misery. Theoretically we know, but practically it is very difficult to give up this kind of activities. So, related to this story, I can tell from my personal experience one person's story. But story is happening till enjoyment. But what the final result, we have to wait. There was one very rich man. He had only one very intelligent son. That son grown up gradually. He studied and very, very intelligent. He studied material education at the same time he practiced some spiritual education also. He studied different shastra, scriptures, and he understood what is the material life and what is the spiritual life. But his parents, when he became youth, his parents want to give marry, but he understood, that's why he left family completely and joined an ashram. And very austere, maintaining very austere life, practicing the devotional service and become nice brahmachari. gradually, he's such a qualified and intelligent person, that's why ashram authority have given a responsibility to establish new ashram temple. Then he satisfied, work hard, and then he established a nice temple and ashram. At the same time, he became some or other come in contact with a donor family. That donor have just husband and wife, no son, anything. But some or other, that man left body and only that Mataji there. The Mataji all times donating, and specially he very much eager to serve the temple president, means the brahmachari, by supplying milk and many things. Every day he personally brought some milk for his service. Then after few months, no more coming that Mataji. Then that brahmachari thinking what happened. Then another one day, one small girl came and in front of his room, just not entering, but she stands. Then that brahmachari asked what happened. Then that girl told that my mother was become that actually they are some daughter, I forgot that they had some daughter, one daughter. And my mother was become so sick that she cannot come. So she sent this milk to you, I brought. And she called you to see because he supposed to left his body. Then that brahmachari came to her room, and then that lady, that Mataji, told the sadhu, brahmachari, that sadhuji, please, because my daughter has no more shelter, so you just see, look after, and at the time when she became youth, then you just take the responsibility to give her marry and whatever necessary. You promise me. Then that brahmachari promised her that, okay, don't think, I will take care. In this way, finally, that Mataji left her body, and now small girl gradually grown up, and that brahmachari became old already in ashram. Then what happened, when that girl became young, that times some boy disturbed, all time disturbed her. Then that girl complained to sadhu brahmachari, what happened? She said, no, how I can live, because all boys are disturbing me all times. Then that sadhu brahmachari, ashram president, he called the leaders of that village, okay, please take care this young girl staying alone, so you are the leader of the village, you should look after. Then some or other settled. After few months, again complain, then but some or other that brahmachari promised that girl's mother, that's why how he can deny, that's why finally he decided, okay, you come nearby ashram and stay here. Otherwise, every times I come to your village and again come this ashram, complain, I have no time. So finally, that girl came to nearby his ashram temple. Then what happened? Now, before she supplied just milk only, now she cooked and different type of seva, service going on. Then finally, that brahmachari sadhu decided that I should settle that girl. I find out some boy and then give marry, then our responsibility will be finished. Think like that. He asked that girl, okay, I decide to give you marry with some other girls. What do you think? No, I don't want to marry except you. Then, very difficult situation. Finally, that old brahmachari agreed to marry her, because some villagers also complained, and so different complicated situation. So think, before that brahmachari was so nice, so service dedicated, austere, but finally he agreed to marry her and then become, in this old age, young girl like this, very complicated situation. That is happening. Then final, what will be final result? That we have to wait. But in Jojati situation, we are getting the what happened already. That Jojati also, now what happened here? As soon as Jojati freed from all the material contamination, then Jojati understood the original position that he was associate of the Supreme Lord, revealed. That is the Jojati's position. So it is very difficult. That's why we have to do our duty according to time, place, circumstances. But at the same time, remember the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction that antare nishtha kari bajya loka vyabohar achirat krishna toma karibe nangikar. In your heart, one should faithful. And externally one may behave like an ordinary man. Then the Lord Krishna delivered from the clutch of Maya. That is sure. It is instructed by the Lord Chaitanya. And also we can remember the instruction to Prachetas by Narad Muni in 4th canto. There mentioned Daya Sarva Bhutesu Santushta Jena Kenova. Daya Sarva Bhutesu Santushta Jena Kenova. Sarvendriya Tushyata Sujanardana. So by showing the mercy to all living entities, being satisfied somehow or other and control the senses from sense enjoyment, one can very quickly satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Janardhan Krishna. So three things, very essential: showing the mercy and satisfied somehow or other and sense control. Then very quickly the Supreme Personality of Godhead will be satisfied. Like here, Jajati finally understood that sense gratification is not the way of the real pleasure, to get real pleasure. So that's why one should convince that he is a spirit soul, part and parcel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's why always remember Krishna. When we externally behave ordinary man, still inside we should always remember Krishna. Otherwise we cannot free from the material bondage. That's why here when Maharaj Jajati delivered Devajani from the oil, then he entangled. But when he understood his constitutional position and after ruling 1,000 years to the earth, still he not satisfied. Then he finally surrendered to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And later on he think, I should perform my duty also. That's why here Srila Prabhupada mentioned that like faithful husband, Maharaj Jajati delivered Devajani from the misconception of material happiness. And finally Devajani also understood. And she understood her liberated husband. And therefore she decided to follow him as his faithful wife, like Vanaprastha life. Although to run our human life very nicely, the Supreme Lord created this varnashram system, brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and finally sannyas, renounce order. But for all ashramas and varnas, it is common instruction that you have to give up all sinful activities and always chant the holy name of the Supreme Lord. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. It is common instruction. But specific instruction for each ashram is there. Like for Brahmachari ashram, every brahmachari must follow. What? That guru seva and swadhyaya means study the shastra. If brahmachari not study the shastra and follow the guru's instruction properly, then that brahmachari ashram not ideal. He cannot remain in brahmachari ashram properly. In brahmachari ashram it is the specific activity. After in grihastha life also special instruction that charity to the for the service of the Supreme Lord and the atithi seva means serve the devotees as a guest, serving the guest. If in grihastha life, if they not give the charity in the service of the Supreme Lord and honor the guest, Brahman and Vaishnavas, then his grihastha life will be not good. Always will be there will be disturbance and he cannot free from this attachment. That's why in every ashram, everyone have to perform their specific duty. And in Banprastha, then Banprastha ashram, one should perform the austerity, like tapasya. Tapasya means just he have to give up what he earned, property, everything, to others, family members. And he completely free from that ownership, his property and money, everything. And full time engage in this devotional service to the Supreme Lord. It is specific duty for Banprastha ashram. And finally, renounce order, sannyas. In sannyas ashram, one completely depend on the Supreme Personality of Godhead and deliver and engage and dedicated himself to the delivered others. Then that ashram will be okay. But finally, everyone have to surrender to the Supreme Lord, then free from fully this material bondage. If we do our duty, then it is easy. Otherwise, if we follow, we can get the lesson from this Jajati's story. Otherwise, we are following if whole story that, oh, Jajati also enter household life and finally attached, and when he understood that this is not no satisfaction, there is no satisfaction. Asahi paramo dukkham nairasyam param supam. If you expect from this, from relatives, from material worlds, from others, and unlimited hope, then there is no satisfaction. Misery, only misery. And nairasyam param sukham. If detachment means vairagya, then happiness. If we not expect anything from others, from this material world, then whatever allotted for me by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that easily we get. But if we ask more and more, then no satisfaction. If not ask, then satisfaction. Like if travel from here to visit another place, expect many things, then nothing facility is there, then we get the misery. If no expectation, then we get many things, then it will for pleasure, happiness. In material world like this. But real happiness, when we come in contact with the service of the Supreme Personality of God, with association of devotees. That is the fact. So, at the same time in this material world, we have to balance our life. Only very minimize things up to for maintaining our body and maximum things to do to satisfy the Supreme Lord. Then easily we can get the mercy, and by the mercy of the Supreme Personality Godhead, it will be easy to free from this material bondage. That's why here it is mentioned that King Jojati completely surrender to the Supreme Personality Godhead, then he was freed from all contamination of the material modes of nature. What percentage we surrender, we free that percentage from this bondage. That's why we are getting some problems also, because we are not fully surrendered. And at the same time, what duty has given, what responsibility has given, we follow proper way according to time, place and circumstances. Otherwise, if you do your things but not according to time, place, circumstances and properly duties, then you have to suffer. Like there was one farmer, he had a dog, an ass, a horse. The dog, usually he serve as a security night time, the dog. And an ass carrying his goods, everything from that farmer's house to market and different places. And horse crops the field. That farmer used that horse to cross the fields. Then every day he very nicely look after dog, ass, horse, very nicely. But in night time he freed the dog, and in one place where that horse and ass stays, then every night that horse, dog and ass discussed what is happening, what going on, and they discuss about that how that they doing so, they working hard but not getting properly from that farmer. So finally they decided to strike. In Bengal they called dharmaghat, hortal, strike. And then leader, the dog is the leader. The dog instructed, okay, as tomorrow you no more carry the goods of that farmer. When farmer keep the goods in your back, you just laying down. You lay down. Okay? Then instructed to the horse, okay, when the farmer ready to cross the field, you just go away. And I, the dog, saying that I no serve as a security, no more talking, just keep quiet. Okay, in this way they started to strike. Then farmer will understand what is our importance. In this way, next day what happened, that farmer think that many goods have to send to market, so he put goods in the back to the ass, and ass laid down. Then farmer thinking, what happened? Why? Maybe some sickness of the ass, anything, he thinking like that. Oh, let me corp the field, use the horse. Then he bring the horse to the field, and when he ready to corpse the field, then the horse ran away. Then farmer thinking, oh, what is happening? He also denied, what going on? He very much disturbed. Then came back to home and think, okay, let me do my office work, marketing, everything finished, and then night time I think, what next day I have to do. Then that farmer, finally he gone to the market, after doing so much work, office work, everything, returned evening, and think, I have to take rest, because very tired. Then he feed the dog, ass, and then night time, again, that horse, ass, and dog discussed. Now, farmer will understand what is our importance. Then dog, ass saying, no, if night time some thief comes, then everything will be taken out from farmer's house. Then what will happen? Next day, this farmer may hand over us to other person, then more difficulties will arise. So we quit from this kinds of strike. Now let us do our duty. But the dog is not agreed. No, my duty yet not finished. Then what happened? Late night, one thief came and entered into the house of the farmer. Then horse and ass insist the dog, okay, shout, otherwise everything will be finished. Then next day, that farmer hand over to other person, then our situation will be more difficult. But dog didn't listen. He kept quiet. Then that ass thinks that I should do that duty. Then farmer will be escape and everything will be saved. Then finally, S was shouting more and more. Then that farmer arise and think, hey, morning time also that S disturbed me, and night time also he is shouting. What happening? He take one bamboo and then came to that place where horse, S and dog stayed. Then he came and started to beaten up that ass. So in this situation, what we think? Ass do nice things because he help for keeping the wealth of the farmer, because that thief ran away seeing the farmer coming with bamboo. But what result? He got punishment. Similarly, if we do our duty, but not according to our right, according to time, place, circumstance, then we have to get also some punishment. That's why not that we doing our duty nicely, everything will be okay. Not like that. Even this king, Jojati, have performed his duty very nicely. But still, some or other, due to sense enjoyment and this material world full of misery, that's why he not satisfied. And finally, he realized his constitutional position, and he gradually and ultimately surrendered to the Supreme Lord. And he himself delivered, and also he helped to deliver his wife, Devajani. It is the final lesson of this chapter. And next few verse there. That's why Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, everyone hearts, and benefiter truthful devotees. So his message that we always remember him, then performed our duty, then easily whatever happened, no problem. Even in small phase, we engage ourselves in devotional service, then it will be very good. And three things, if we always remember, then we are no more fallen in this kind of sense enjoyment. I very much again and again remember that sloka what I already told, that daya sarvabhutesu santushta jena kano va sarvendra upashanta tushyata sujanardana. Same thing happened here. Okay, Hare Krishna, thank you very much. Because I am not always speaking in English, that's why to express my experience and concern is very difficult. Anyway, please forgive me. I think Bhagavat Katha, some other, it not properly, but I just tried to relate the Prabhupada's teachings related to this sloka. Hare Krishna, thank you, please forgive me. Hare Krishna, yes Prabhu. Microphone. Comments.
You mentioned that in the last order of life people become fully dependent on Krishna. And then also I guess for a devotee, devotees are always dependent on Krishna. Is that to be understood? Yes. Sometimes it seems like we're dependent on the demons, actually, you know, in our lives. Like we, just like money, you know, we can't get through the day without having money, spending money. But all money is, you know, whether it's dollars, rupees, or anything you get out of the currency exchange in the long building, its only value is what's certified by the demons, actually. You know, the people who run the banks, they decide how much a rupee is worth. There's no value except for that it's just pieces of paper, except that, you know, that it has a sort of like it's authorized, you know, and then we depend on that very much, and then our bank balances and the money that comes into Mayapur through, you know, that for the TOVP and all the salaries for all the different devotees, you know, they have to have all that so that they to be able to do their service. They have to have it seems like in so many ways are we dependent on Krishna, or are we dependent on the material energy that's sustaining us?
Thank you very much. Actually, in Bengali there is a proverb, "Ortho anorther mool," means that money is the source of the misery. But at the same time, if money and wealth utilized in the service of the Supreme Lord, then it will become paramartho, means spiritual. That is the fact. We need money, but if we serve the Supreme Personality Godhead, then money and other things like Lord, known as also Lakshmipati, the husband of the Lakshmi. So Lakshmi will follow if we serve the Narayan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If we only depend on the Lakshmi or money, then Lakshmi is not, Lakshmi always chanchal, means flicker, all the time coming and going, not stayed at one place. But if we keep with us the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayan, then Lakshmi will be there. Always, because Lakshmi always follow Narayan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the fact. And demons like Maya, it within our heart. Maya at the Sura and Asura both are now in this age of Kali. I heard from one Puran that in Satyayug, they are demons and demigods in separate, like demigods were in heavenly planets and demons are the lower planets. And when Sattva-gun arise, then the demigods become powerful. And when Rajo and Tamo-gun, means mode of passion and ignorance, arise, then demons become powerful. And then they came up and they was down fighting. And by when demigods become in difficulties, they depend on the Supreme Personality Godhead. Then finally, by the instruction of Supreme Personality Godhead, demigods will be saved. And later on, in Dwapar Yug, they come and closure, like Ravan, Kumbhakarna appeared in this world, and in the same time, the different kinds of demigods appeared as a in human beings, different species, and Lord Ramchandra came, and just demon Ravan will be finished. And next, Dwapar Yug, that more closure, in one family, demons appeared, like Duryodhan, Dushasan, and others, Kauravas. And demigods appeared as a Yudhishthir, Bhim, Arjun, Pandavas, and fighting just battle of Kurukshetra. And finally, Lord Krishna appeared, and they will saved, Dharma saved by the Pandavas. And in the age of Kali, what happened? The demons and the qualities of demons and qualities of demigods, both are in one person, within our heart. That's why how the Supreme Lord killed. If killed, then everything will be finished. That's why this age, not Supreme Personality of Godhead appeared. He appeared as a devotee, like Lord Chaitanya. And he think, Ebe nam sankirtan tikhna khadgaloya antar asur jiver kativa phelia. Means, now I just finished, I will be finished the demons by the sword of this sankirtan, the holy name. Then devotee, demigod's qualities will be saved, and they perform this service. That is the fact. And after mentioned, it is mentioned in Chaitanya Mangal, the one life story of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by Lochan Das Thakur, that jodi papi dharma chadi dur deshe jaye, mor senapati bhakta jaibe to thai. If some flew away some other place, then my senapati bhakta, like it indicates Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada travels all over the world and just by spreading Krishna consciousness movement, he saved this world in this way. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prediction also fulfilled. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Ram. Thank you very much. Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande, Hare Hare Bol.